You will now learn about the important features of the graph and signal definitions window. You can see the details of the individual signals by clicking on the plus to the left of the relevant signal. The parameters name, unit, and time base are important. You can see that the name is transferred from the signal to the graph and to the signal definitions list. The unit is also transferred to the graph and the unit column of the signal definitions list. The time base is here and is the resolution of the signal in the graph. You can mask or unmask the signals. In this case, I will mask the signal by clicking either on this arrow on the right of the graph or on the show box in the signal definitions list. I will click on the arrow in this case. You can see that the signal has disappeared and the show box tick has gone. It can be redisplayed by clicking either on the show box or on the downward pointing arrow in the graph window. You can select the color of the graph by clicking on the color column and then selecting one of the available colors. It is also possible to shift graphs to different positions in the graph window or to move one graph into a second graph. In the first case, you select the name of the graph you want to move, click on it and drag it into the tramlines of the graph under which it is to be displayed. The second possibility is to again click on the name of the graph you want to shift and drag it into the axis of the graph you want to shift it into. This produces a graph with a common y-scale. The third possibility is again to click on the name of the graph and drag it into the graph where you want to display it. In this case, each graph has its own individual y-scale.